Here, we are going to devise a drive to transfer motion under two conditions. Number one, the velocity ratio should remain steady all the time. And number two, there should not be any slip under any load condition. That is, the drive should be positive. Let us start with the first condition, the constant velocity ratio. It is typically met by belt drives like the one shown here. It consists of two pulleys connected with, say, a cross belt. Now, this drive gives us a constant velocity ratio, but at higher loads, there could be slip. That is, the driver pulley may roll, but the driven pulley may not roll to the expected extent. And this happens because we are using a force which is not very reliable, the force of friction, which cannot increase beyond a certain limit. So instead of using this force where the motion is tangential, let us use a force where the contact is normal. So a direct push is applied. That is the force of contact or the normal reaction. So we are going to replace the tension in the belt by normal reaction. For that, we will need a contact between the two pulleys. Since they are far apart, we will have to extend them. And the extension should be such that the contact should be retained even after the pulleys roll. There is a simple trick to achieve this, and that is, we will take a point P on the belt and put a pencil there and draw a shape or a profile or an extension on both the pulleys simultaneously. Since both these extensions or profiles are drawn by a common pencil, they will definitely make a contact at that point, and so the contact will be maintained. To understand what kind of profile this generates, let us concentrate on any one of these pulleys and use this setup. Over here, this is the pulley. To it, a cardboard is attached on which we can draw. Instead of belt, we have this inextensible string, and on it there is a pencil. Let us set this in motion, and you can see as the string unwinds and the pulley rotates, relative to that pulley on the cardboard, a curve is getting traced. Now, by definition, a point on an inextensible string getting unbound from a circle traces an involute. So what we are getting here is an involute. Now, as the string is getting unwound from one pulley, it is getting wound on the other. And it doesn't matter whether we are winding or unwinding, relative to the pulley, a point on that string will always trace an involute. So we are not only tracing an involute on one pulley, but relative to the other as well. And these two involutes will always make a contact. So this is how it looks. So there is a green involute on green pulley, and the red one is getting traced on the red one, and they are always making a contact, and a direct push is applied, thereby the motion is transferred. So there is no chance of slip. So we are not only getting a constant velocity ratio, but we are also getting a positive drive. The best of both worlds, and now we can call this a gear. And because we are using involute profile, these gearing is called involute gearing. We must bear in mind that these two profiles work together as a team to give us a positive drive with constant velocity ratio. They will not work individually. So therefore, they are kind of wedded together, an involute working with another involute, and are called as conjugate profiles. Lastly, an observation we can make that as the two involutes are generated, their lengths are not equal. The red one is growing very fast, and therefore it will slide past the green involute. So there will be sliding. At a later stage, the green one is growing faster than the red, so that will slide past the red profile, and therefore there will be sliding all the time. Of course, between these two stages, there is a single point at which both are growing or lengthening at the same rate, and there will not be any sliding. We will see later that it happens at this point P shown here on the line joining their centers, and it is called as a pitch point.